head shot.
Drink.
Sit down.
Drink.
Stand up.
Drink.
Pass out.
Drink.
Wake up.
Drink.
Fade it.
Drink.
Fade it.
Drink.
3, 2, 1. It's hard to call it radio when it's this out of the box.
Man, you know just what to say.
You might be a redneck.
Here it is.
Fox News alert on several dramatic new developments.
Frank Sinatra.
You're a delightful audience.
Let's go to Margaritaville, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown.
This is satellite radio. Welcome to SiriusXM.
Now, if you want to sign up for SiriusXM yourself, see all the great features and channels that has to offer, definitely go to tinyurl.com/SiriusXM CEO Radio. It's all one word. Again, that's tinyurl.com/SiriusXM CEO Radio, all one word. Or you can go directly to our website, CEORadio.live. That's CEO Radio, all one word, .live. Click on one of the mini SiriusXM links there. You can sign up through us. We'll get you a good deal. And, you know, I'll give you a chance to check out a lot of the other great content that's available on SiriusXM, such as the All Out Show with Rude Jude, Monday through Friday, 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Shout out to Rude Jude. Definitely check out his books, by the way. He's got Hyena and Hummingbird. Fucking awesome books. And he's actually making a cartoon out of one of the books. So be on the lookout for that shit. Big shout out to everyone down there at SiriusXM. Big shout out to everyone at the fucking All Out Show. And we're going to go ahead and continue with the Drunk Mix. Well, you know, we can't call it the Drunk Mix because Lord Sirius bitch ass owns that shit. Even though I think I do it better. But yeah, I'm drunk and we're in the mix, so fuck it. You know, I had to call out Lord Sir, though, because now, I don't take part in whatever his issues and Jude's issues are. You know, I've heard different rumors here and there. That's their own thing. I call in to Lord Sears' show because he's talking about fucking wanting to hear crazy stories about being an Uber driver, a cab driver, driving people around. So I figured, fuck it, I fall in that category. I drove around fucking escorts. I drove for an escort company. So I called to tell one of my crazy stories because, I mean, what kind of fucking crazy stories you come up with being an Uber driver compared to driving fucking escorts around? Like, that's the height of your crazy stories right there. I get halfway in, this motherfucker hangs up on me. I think I got too real for him. Not even halfway in. I was telling a crazy ass story. So I'm going to tell the story here. Since Lord Sear, that little fat fucker, wanted to cut me off. Yeah, Lord Sear, I'm calling you out. If you got an issue with it, get in contact with me. But, nah, man, like, I used to drive escorts around for a while. Because, well, basically what happened was, I was going through some financial shit with my divorce. I had a roommate steal a bunch of money from my house right before fucking Christmas, and I was newly a single father. Like, I've been a single father for about, I don't really share that part of my life too much, but, so, y'all know, I've raised my kids on my own for fucking about 5 years now. And, shit, I was just brand new to being a single father, so I'm struggling. Because you already know, you know, women, if a woman has a man that fucking takes off on her with and leaves her with the kids, she getting child support instantly. They cutting paychecks, all that shit. A man fucking does. I'm fuck 5 years in. I still ain't got a dime of child support from this bitch. That's a whole nother story though. But you know, I had a roommate steal some money from me and take off right before the fucking holidays too. So I mean, on top of when you're a single parent. All the single parents out there, mothers and fathers alike, y'all know what it is, man. Money's tight, and if someone steals from you, this fucking makes it hella tight, but especially during the fucking holidays, man. Right before the holidays, so I'm struggling. I went to go do this business where I was going to sell Obama phones. At the time, I still had a warrant, had a little legal shit going on, so they're like, nah, they did a background check to give away free phones. They do a background check. How fucked up is that? So they do a background check. They said, no, they cut me off, like, my second day. I was like, damn it. Stressing and shit. And then, sure enough, my fucking, my big sister Kennedy hits me up, big shout out to Kennedy and Lord. And, she's like, hey, you know, I'm doing this legal escort shit. You want to fucking be a driver? I said, hell yeah. hell yeah. She's like, I can help you out. You know, I know you're in your situation right now with your money. I said, hell yeah, definitely use that. So I'm driving around. And it was a pretty chill job, you know. I mean, I fucking dropped the girls off at whatever event they were attending or whatever they were fucking doing. I'd wait in the nearby parking lot, just watch Netflix, my phone, kick it. This dude's having a party with his homies at some hotel. He wants a stripper to come by. We bring a girl to him. He's all tweaked out and shit, little 19-year-old tweaker. Fuck you, bring a girl to him. Go back to watching Netflix in my car. I was finishing up a movie. I was watching Horrible Bosses 2. It was a movie. I watched part of it on the last call. I was going to finish up the last part on this call. And next thing I know, my phone's blowing up. I'm like, what the fuck? And all his homies left. He wanted to lock her in the goddamn room. I was like, oh, hell no. And, you know, normally, because I did driver and security was my pretty much job title. I did security as well. I was an armed security guard. Not licensed, but I was armed because it was Arizona and you could be armed, and I was doing security. So I'm like, all right, shit. So I grabbed the burner up, the glove box, put that shit on the waistband, go run up in this hotel. And it's not the hotel that is outside, like the doors are outside and shit. It's one of those you got to go inside through some hallways and elevators and shit like that to get to the rooms. A little bit nicer hotel. This little fucking foreign dude, I don't know what country he's from. He barely speaks English, so I'm trying to explain to him, hey, I'm not trying to tell him, I got a stripper up here who's getting locked in the room and shit. I'm just like, hey, my homegirl's up here, she really needs some help right now, I gotta go see her real quick, let her know I'm here. He said, what room? And I'm like, man, I can't tell you that, because I figured if he goes up there, it's gonna cause more problems and more shit like that. I'm like, I just gotta go up there. He wants to argue with me. The whole time he's arguing with me, I don't know how severe the situation is in this room. I don't know if it's just dude locked her in the room or fucking it's the worst shit happening. So I'm already assuming the worst. Like, as I'm arguing with dude, I'm like, damn, she's probably getting raped right now, getting stabbed, all sorts of shit. So I finally grab this little dude by the shoulders and like, hey, man, I ain't got time to deal with you. I'm sorry. And I just kind of pushed him aside. He fell on the ground, made it all dramatic. I start running. I'm running through the hotel. He's threatening to call the police. I fucking get up to this hotel room and I hear the dude inside talking shit. Talking about, you ain't leaving this motherfucker, all that shit. I said, all right, watch this. Bang on the door. Boom, boom, boom. Phoenix Police Department, open the door. I hear him stop. He says, you called the fucking cops? All scared and shit. He opens the door all quiet with his hands up. I put the burner in his mouth, threw him against the wall with the fucking gun in his mouth and shit. Told the girl, hey, grab that money real quick. Grab that shit. She grabs the money off the table. We take off running and shit. We fucking dip out that motherfucker, man. That was like the worst shit I ever had to go through as an escort driver. Like, that was the only time I really had to get physical with someone like that. And I'm leaving there, and the cops run away. I'm like thinking, how fucked am I right now? I'm driving around an escort. It's a legal company, but I don't know if I have to be licensed to do this shit. And on top of it, I just assaulted the hotel owner and put a gun in someone's mouth in the hotel room. Like, it was a crazy ass night, man. But got a little song coming up for everyone out there. That, every now and then, everyone jumps on a grenade sometimes. Let's just put it that way. I mean, you know, everyone, I mean, you may know the homie, all he gets is fine bitches, but at the end of the day, no matter how many gold coins someone has, we all got a few pennies we ain't proud of in our past, you know what I'm talking about? But that's why God made liquor, because you can drink that alcohol and it makes them prettier. Let's get into Bloodhound Gang, Pretty When I'm Drunk, check it out.
To slip free brew and go fuzzy flounder fishing. Cages on the hi-fi and the keg was bottomless. Until we brought Skipopotamus and Daddy gonna get some probably underage and dumb. And everybody knows that the daddy eats his young. Lupus in the laboratory making a big stink. Mason up the toilet seat and pooping in the sink. MSG's tanked up and whizzing in a cup. Waiting for a sprinkle genie to come and drink it up. Cause I'm the one bottle willy with the 12 horse ale. After that I get silly like soupy sails. Now it's midnight and I'm completely boofy blitzed. A six of Schlitz and the Juber Man of Shevitz with my beer tinted glasses. I'm ready to biddy battle. I'm hungry like the wolf, but I'll end up tending cattle. Cause you're pretty when I'm drunk.
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 And I'm pretty fucking drunk.
she comes. A funky fried cutie, Mr. Jimmy Pop-Ali is gonna get some booty, cause I'm Mr. McFeely with a speedy delivery. You think I was a ditch away, this chick was digging me, but maybe I should check and see if this is where I wanna be. Hey Lupus, is she cute?
Yeah, for a pygmy.
Oh, what do you know? You're probably going home alone, and it wouldn't be the first time that I gave a dog a bone. Plus beauty, it's only skin deep, it's in the eye of the beholder. My beholder's about to tweak. I could tap that barrel, in fact I know I can. It's menage a trois, you and me and Heineken. Cause you're pretty when I'm drunk.
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 And I'm pretty fucking drunk.
Regrets, I've had a few. First and foremost, I'd like to mention you. For the sake of conversation, we'll call you the brand new heavy. You're a mix between an Ugnaught and Eugene Levy. You can call it Big Bone, I prefer to call it Gut. You're Buddha, you're Shamu, you're Jabba the fucking Hutt. You had harpoon scars, and your boobs were hairy. I smelled tuna melt, but I wasn't gonna worry. It was 3 a.m., and I wasn't getting squats, so I rolled you up in flour and aimed it for the wet spot. Like a soup kitchen Christian. Then it hit me, something bit me while my little rod was fishing. I was deep sea fishing. I took a fat chance, but how was I supposed to know that Jabber Jaws lived in your pants at that junction? I came to realize that only Frank Perdue likes thighs that size. Fatty, fatty, boom, laddy. I gotta lament that you were not a girl. You were an experiment. Cause you're pretty when I'm drunk.
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 And I'm pretty fucking drunk.
You're pretty when I'm 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 drunk.
And I'm pretty fucking drunk.
Get into some Sublime. Big shout out to Sublime with Rome, by the way. Like I mentioned before, fucking got to meet them over at the Grand Sierra Resort. Fucking awesome dudes, man. Awesome fucking guys. Very humble. That was actually my second time meeting them. I met them the first time in Phoenix, Arizona. They were at the State Fair. The State Fair, you know, they got, if you ain't ever been to the Arizona State Fair concerts, they've got where you can go in free entry to the concerts and see it for free just because you've got a ticket to the fair. But then they have this reserved seating that's like super close to the stage, and that costs, you have to get tickets and shit like that. I was just going to go to the free fucking area. Figured fucking I'm already at the fair. I'm drinking their $12 beers and shit. I deserve a free concert. So I fucking start walking up there, and this guy comes out and he's all bummed out. He's like, hey man, my friends bailed on me. You want these fucking tickets? And I looked, they're two fucking rows back from the stage. I said, hell yeah, bro. I walked up in there. First